Dear students, in this video we are going to understand about reducing and oxidizing agents. We are going to understand about reducing and oxidizing agents. Okay. So reducing and oxidizing agents. These concepts are little bit confusing, but if you understand the trick, if you can focus on the trick to figure out reduction, oxidation and the agents, because sometimes the students they get confused about oxidation and oxidizing agents, reduction reducing agents. So for that I'm giving you an example to make you understand the concepts so that you will understand easily. Whenever you face difficulty, whenever you forget the concept, you just try to recall this reaction, or you can recall any other reaction if you like, and all of your problems and confusions will be sorted out. So my dear students, before we go to understand reducing and oxidizing agents, let us have the other definitions of oxidation and reduction which you have already studied in your junior classes. So oxidation is defined as gain of oxygen, okay, gain of oxygen or removal of hydrogen. So when an element is gaining oxygen, then you can say that element is undergoing oxidation. Or if an element is removing hydrogen, or yani if hydrogen is being removed from a substance, then you can say that substance is undergoing oxidation. Similarly, reduction is gain of hydrogen. It's just the opposite of oxidation. Gain of hydrogen or is removal of oxygen. Okay. Let us have examples. So for the first case, oxidation, carbon, if you add oxygen to it, you will get carbon dioxide. So you can see this is a simple reaction. Carbon is an element, it is gaining oxygen to form carbon dioxide. Oxygen is being added to this, that is why we can say carbon is undergoing oxidation. Okay, but for this example, H2S Cl2 2HCl plus S. You don't have oxygen over here. Then how can you say that oxidation or reduction is happening? But you have hydrogen over here. So you can see, my dear students, that H2S is getting transformed into sulfur. H2S is getting transformed into sulfur, isn't it? So hydrogen sulfide is getting rid of hydrogen. Hydrogen sulfide is getting rid of hydrogen for getting transformed into sulfur. Hai na? No hydrogen is there. Isme se hydrogen nikal ja raha hai. So when the removal of hydrogen is involved, we say that is also oxidation. So H2S is undergoing oxidation. H2S is undergoing oxidation. Now reduction, my dear students, reduction, let us take example of reduction. Reduction is what? Addition of hydrogen. So in this very example, chlorine is gaining hydrogen from here to transform into HCl. So we can say that chlorine is gaining hydrogen, so it is undergoing reduction, isn't it? Chlorine is undergoing reduction. Why? Because it is taking hydrogen from hydrogen sulfide. So this is how reaction takes place. Now let us try to understand about the reducing agent and the oxidizing agent. I'm writing this reaction again afresh so that it has become a hodgepodge there. So it will be a difficult task to understand. I'm writing that reaction again. So H2S plus Cl2 is giving us 2HCl plus S. So my dear students, you can see H2S is losing hydrogen and is becoming sulfur. So you can say this is oxidation. This is what? Oxidation. Chlorine is gaining hydrogen and it is become HCl. So this is definitely a reduction. This is definitely a reduction. Okay. Now, reducing agent and oxidizing agent. Very simple. Just focus. See, reduction is the process. An agent is the substance. So if an element is either gaining an electron or is gaining hydrogen or is removing oxygen, then you can say that element or substance is undergoing reduction. Usme reduction ho raha hai. If it is gaining electron, if it is gaining hydrogen, or it is losing oxygen, you can say that substance is undergoing reduction. But that is not an agent. Agent means a substance, an individual that helps that substance to get reduced. एक ऐसा बाहरी substance होगा जो उसको reduce होने में मदद करेगा. That will be the reducing agent. So in this particular case, chlorine is getting reduced, isn't it? Chlorine is getting reduced. मतलब ये reduce हो रहा है. It is undergoing reduction. Who is helping chlorine to get reduced? From where? In simple words, from where it is getting this hydrogen? It is getting hydrogen from here. So you can say, we can say that H2S is the reducing agent. Yes, H2S is the reducing agent. Similarly, what is oxidation? Oxidation, a substance when loses an electron or gains oxygen or removes hydrogen, you can say that substance is undergoing oxidation. Oxidation. And a substance which helps that substance to get oxidized is the oxidizing agent. Matlab, in simple words, in this example, H2S is getting oxidized. That is, it is losing hydrogen. Okay? Oxidation can be done either by the loss of electron or by the gain of oxygen or by the removal of hydrogen. So in this case, this substance, hydrogen sulfide, this compound is losing hydrogen and thereby undergoing oxidation. Who is helping H2S to get oxidized? Clearly chlorine. Chlorine is taking the hydrogen, na? So chlorine is helping H2S to get oxidized. So in this case, chlorine is the oxidizing agent. So in simple words, the trick is the substance which get reduced is the oxidizing agent and the substance which get oxidized is the reducing agent. Just turn the table around, you will get the answer. What is that? Oxidized substance is the reducing agent. That's the trick. And reduced substance is the oxidizing agent. Okay, this is the conclusion of the video. I hope you understood. Inshallah, we will be learning other topics in the next. I will be uploading next a couple of more videos